Getting started in VideoStudio is easy. In this tutorial, we'll dive in and show you the basics. You'll learn how to import video clips to the library, use templates, add your clips and photos, review and trim your video clips, as well as add titles, transitions, and music. Then we'll take a look at saving and sharing your project. Let's start with the most common situation. You have video and photos that you've taken, and you want to make a movie. Let's import them into VideoStudio. We can open up VideoStudio Pro, and I'm going to jump right to the Edit tab. This brings me into the Edit workspace. Clicking on the Add icon at the top will allow me to create a project folder for my project. I'm actually going to call this My First Project. The libraries are the source of all of your media, including video clips, photos, and music. It also houses templates. By clicking on the Import Media Files, I can browse to where my content is. I'll select this content and simply click Open. You'll notice how quick that comes in. Now you'll notice the buttons at the top. I have the ability to toggle on and off the view for videos, still images, and audio track. Now that I have my content in, there's a couple of ways I can proceed. I can start with an instant project. You'll note that we have beginnings, middles, endings, or complete projects. I'm going to drag and drop this complete project onto my timeline, and you can see how easy it is to drop that in. You'll see I have a number of different placeholders in here. I'm going to go back to my media content and simply drag and drop onto the placeholder. Now when I drop it on the placeholder, I want to hold the control key down. It will actually swap out the placeholder with my content. I'm going to bring a couple of more images in. Again, holding down the control key, drag and drop. Let's rewind this and play. You'll see how easy it was to start off with this project. Okay, what we're going to do is I'm going to go to the File menu. I'm going to select New Project. There's no need to save this. And we're going to go on and continue with our project. Adding clips and photos to a video project is as easy as dragging and dropping. VideoStudio makes it easy to trim unwanted content from your clip to keep the clip interesting. Or you can also cut the clip and insert a transition or still image. You can trim video clips in the timeline itself by dragging the end handles of the clip. Or you can position the scrubber within the clip to take out a section. Now here I can either click on the scissors or simply tap the letter S, and that will allow me to cut that clip. I'm going to select this portion and I'm going to delete that. Now I can also use the MultiTrim Editor. By double-clicking on a clip, it's going to open up the Options panel for me. Here we have a number of different things that I can do. For example, under Color Correction, I can change the hue, I can adjust the saturation of a clip, adjust brightness, contrast, and of course adjust the gamma. Any of these settings I change, if I wish to reset them, it's simply a matter of double-clicking on the control, and that will reset those settings. Let me close off the Color Correction tab. You'll notice that we have speed controls. I can set speed or time lapse as well as variable speed. I reverse my video. I can split audio, split by scene, or of course I have the multi-trim video. I'm going to click on the multi-trim video, and this is going to open up my clip in the multi-trim editor. In the multi-trim editor, it's simply a matter of using my scrubber to move along the clip to a portion that I want. I'm going to start at the beginning of the clip, and I'll move my scrubber along so that I can capture the portion that I want. You'll notice that my cursor is going off screen. That's not a problem at all. I'm going to do my end cursor, or my end out rather. And you'll see that this piece of the clip that I've selected has dropped down into this trimmed panel. I'm going to move quite a bit further. I'll mark my in, I'll scrub along a little bit further, and I'm going to mark the out. That's all there is to it. So I've taken that clip, I've cut it down to two smaller pieces. I'll simply click OK, and it's going to be updated in my timeline. Let me zoom to the entire project, and here we have the three pieces that are now in my timeline. Now, one of the other libraries that I mentioned was the graphics library. In the graphics library, we have solid color patterns. I'm going to drag and drop one of this to the end of my project. I also have color patterns, backgrounds, frames, objects, and animations. Now, of course, the frames, objects, and animations support alpha channel or support transparency. So if I drag and drop one of these onto an overlay track, you'll be able to see what's on the primary track in the transparent portion of this image. Let me just do a Control Z to undo that. I'm going to go to my backgrounds, and I want to drag and drop this background into the center of these two clips. You see, it's automatically added that, it's automatically moved that over. Let me just go back to the beginning. Now, by making use of an overlay track, I can have content on the screen at the same time as my main track. To access the overlay tracks, I'm going to click on the track manager, and in here you can see I have a video track, I have a number of overlay tracks that I can make use of, as well as title tracks, voice tracks, and music tracks. I'm going to increase the number of overlay tracks to 3. I'll simply click OK to this, and that now has added additional overlay tracks for me that I can bring content in. I'm going to go back to my media library, and I'm going to drag a couple of other images in. I'm going to drag and drop these over top of this background. And I'll just move along a little bit and bring the final clip in. Now you'll notice that when I brought this clip in, if I left click at the end of it, I have the ability to change the duration of this. Currently that's set to 5 seconds. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select this background image, and I'll do the same. I'm going to left click on this, and I'll drag it to the end of this clip. Now, you saw me early on when I double clicked on this track, it brings me into the options. I'll close this off. If I double click on a still image, it will do the same. It brings me into the options. In the options, I have things such as the edit tab, which allows me for color correction. We can apply pan and zoom. I can rotate my image. If I go into the attributes, I have such things as mask and chroma key. So I can actually add a frame around this image. Let me just add a small white frame around this. And now I'm going to right click on this clip, and I'm going to copy attributes. Now, if I select these two images and right click, I can now paste all attributes. And what that's done is it's actually put a frame around all three images. But let me just go back. I want to make one more change to this. I'm going to make this image a little bit bigger, and I'll position this in here. Note that I can change the size by clicking on this yellow rectangle. Now, let's copy those attributes once again, because I want to make sure that all three images are the same size. There we have it. Now what I'm going to do is on this first image, I'll double click it. It takes me into the attributes panel, and here I can dictate how this image comes on screen. This particular image, I want it to come in from the left, and I want it to fade out. The second image, I want it to fade in and fade out. And then the third image, I want that to fade in and exit to the right. Let's rewind that and we'll see how that looks. So it comes in from the left, fades out, the next one fades in, it fades out, and the third one fades in and will exit right. Okay, I'm happy with that. Over on the right-hand side, I have the ability to zoom in and zoom out on my project. If I click on this double-ended arrow, it's actually going to fit the entire project to my timeline. Let's take a look at a couple of the transitions now. If I go to my transitions library, you'll notice that I have quite a number of different transitions. I can scroll through here and pick any one of these transitions. It simply matters selecting the transition, dragging and dropping onto the timeline, and that will then apply that transition. I'm going to play this. So very quick and very easy. I'm going to remove this transition. I don't want that one. I want to use one called Crossfade. Now, in the drop down, you'll notice that I have my favorites. I also have the ability to sort my transitions. In my favorites, if there's a particular transition I happen to like, I can put it in here, and that saves me having to look for it later on. Let me just go back to effects, because that's where my crossfade is. I'll select the crossfade transition, and I'm going to add it to my favorites. It's as simple as that. Let me go to 3D. I'll grab the flip fly. I'm going to add that to my favorites. I like to use that to show time passing. If I now go to my favorites, you'll see that I have the crossfade and the flip fly here. I'm simply going to add these transitions between these images. And these are crossfades, so drag and drop. And we will put one at the very end. Now it's time to add some music to our project. Let me go back to my main media library. I'm going to take my scrubber, bring it back to the beginning. And on my timeline, you can see I have something called Auto Music. Now I can certainly bring in my own audio track, and I'm going to be doing it for this project, but I do want to show you the Auto Music. Clicking on Auto Music, you can see I've got a number of different categories. I can dial up any one of these, get a sample or a preview of it. Now, one of the nice things about the auto music is it will automatically fit to the duration of your project. So all I need to do is, once I've selected the track that I want, I simply click on Add to Timeline. And look at this. It's gone right to the very end of my project. Now, I'm going to take this track and I'll delete that. I want to use my own. I'm going to use one called Goose Calls. So just simply drag and drop this onto my audio track. I'll zoom to the entire project. And I can left click and drag and bring this back to the end. Now, let's take a quick look at my sound mixer. If I select Sound Mixer, in here we can see we have the ability to control the volumes of the different audio tracks. I can also set where the sound is coming from. And as I move this around, if I'm playing the track, it's actually going to put keyframes in. But what I want to do here is I'm going to adjust some volumes. Now, we can see the waveform in here. If I do a single click on this band, we call it a rubber band, I'll do another click and I've added a keyframe. I can pull this down. What that's going to do is it's going to lower the volume of the drone that you heard in the background. Let me just drag that right down. So very quick and very easy, I've now lowered the volume in the audio. And let me just play this little section so you can see what I mean. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I want to add some voice narration to this. Adding voice narration, very easy in VideoStudio. Let me get out of my sound mixer. I'll go into Record Capture Options. And I'll do Voice Over. Now the Voice Over works quite nice. All I need to do is adjust my input level based on the microphone that I'm currently using. I'll do a test, testing 1, 2, 3. I can do a recording as well. This will give me a 5-second recording that then gets played back, and so I can hear this well. This will give me a 5-second recording that then gets played back, and that gives me an idea as to the volume level if it's suitable. I kind of like that volume. I'm going to click on Start and start my recording. Once I've finished the recording, it's simply a matter of tapping the space bar. That will end the recording and it will drop the track onto my timeline. The concept behind the Goosebuster is to humanely remove geese and migratory waterfowl from beaches and parks. And that's all there is to it. Now that I've added my voiceover, the final thing to do is to add a couple of titles. Clicking on the Titles library, you can see I have a number of different titles in here. I also have a My Favorites folder. So I'm going to go to My Favorites. I'm going to grab my first title, drag and drop that onto my timeline. And if I double click it, I then have the ability to edit the title. I can position the title on the screen. I'm going to change the spacing just a little bit. And as you can see, there's quite a lot of flexibility in here. If I wanted to add a drop shadow or a border around it, I can certainly do that. I'm now going to take my title, I'll left click and drag, and I want to make sure it's set to the same duration as the track above it. I'm going to add the title to the end of it. And double click, and I can go ahead and add my text in here. I'll simply resize this. And you'll notice as well, I've mentioned these little yellow squares gives me the ability to resize my text. The pink dots allows me to rotate the title. So let me just go ahead and I'm going to change the font on this. I'll make it a little bit larger, and I'm going to set the spacing a little bit heavier. All right, I'm happy with that. I'm going to close off the options panel, rewind this back to the beginning. I'm going to go ahead and play the project through, make sure I'm happy with it, and if I am, then we're going to go ahead and share this out. The concept behind the Goosebuster is to humanely remove geese and migratory waterfowl from beaches and parks. Okay, that's not too bad. I see a couple of issues or a couple of places where I could fix this up, and this is one of the reasons why we play this back before rendering it out. And that's all there is to it. I'm finished with the project, I'm happy with it, and now it's a matter of saving it and sharing it. So from the File menu, I'll go down to Save As, and I'll simply call it My Project. I'll click on Save. Now, from the Share tab, this gives me the ability to render the file out. You'll notice that I have a number of different options. I can render it to the computer itself. I can render it out for a device, such as a smartphone. I can send it out to the web. I can create a DVD. Now, when creating a DVD, we do offer full menu capabilities as well. Or I can render it out as a 3D video. I'm going to select web. And here you can see I can send it to YouTube, Facebook, Flickr, or Vimeo. I'm going to select Facebook, and I'm going to upload this to my Facebook page. Because I've already logged into Facebook, I have the ability of giving it a title. I'm just going to leave this as My Video. I can set a full description, and also set the privacy settings as to who I want to see this. I'm going to click on Start and let this video render out. I want to thank you very much for your time, and if you're looking for more information, more tutorials on Corel Video Studio Pro X9, do visit the Discovery Center at learn.corel.com.